Hey guys, Bernard Faria here.
And I'm Malcolm Gwillem.
Guys, I'm here today with him. He's a physical conditioning coach and also nutritionist. He's one of the best physical conditioning coaches out there. And today he's gonna show us five exercises specific for BJJ. And it's very cool to see because I used to work with KP, Kevin Paretti, that in my opinion is one of the best conditioning coaches in the world as well. And they have pretty much the same principles. They approach it pretty much in the same way. They do the periodization training and they do a bunch of like specific trainings for jiu-jitsu. So it's very cool to see that the best guys have kind of the same formula. And guys, one of his mentors is Charles Poliquin. And this is the guy who has worked with over 800 Olympic athletes. And for these 800 Olympic athletes, over 20 got gold medals. So it's probably like the best guy out there. And this guy mentioned his name as the next guy. So this guy mentioned Malcolm's name as the next Charles. So you guys can imagine how high is his level. And I love to have this experience, like to exchange ideas with him and to see like all the hard work I put with KP. And see that he does pretty much the same thing. It's like, I'm not gonna say the same thing, but kind of like same formula. So it's gonna be very cool to see what he has here today. And
all right guys, I'm gonna give you just a quick background on myself. I'm originally from Vancouver, Canada. I grew up playing professional sports and I was fortunate enough to get a scholarship, Division I hockey scholarship to Michigan Tech University. From there, I went on to play 3 years of professional hockey and moved to Arizona to pursue my strength and conditioning career. From there, I've learned under my mentor, Charles Poliquin, and I've trained some very high profile clients, most notably Will Clay, who won the silver medal in triple jump in Rio, and Victoria Anthony, who's a national champion in wrestling and placed fifth at the World Championships this year. I've worked with BJJ and professional athletes in the NFL, NHL, and today I'm gonna be working with Bernardo. I'm gonna be showing him five exercises that will improve your performance on the mat.
Let's do it. Okay guys, so first exercise here, Malcolm's gonna show us a very good exercise for grips. So let's see how he does it.
All right, so what we know about BJJ is that grip strength is a limiting factor, or can be, in a match. So we have a couple tools here today that we're gonna use that can improve grip strength. One is being a pinch plate. So a pinch plate, this is about a quarter of an inch. We're going to attach it to a loading pin that has a weight on it. And Bernardo is going to pinch the plate as hard as he can with his arm extended. And he's going to hold that for about 60 seconds, okay, until his pinch fails. Then he's going to switch hands. He's going to do the same thing on the opposite hand. From there, we're going to switch the diameter of the pinching grip plate to an oscillating grip. So that means that his fingers are going to rest on the inside, and he's gonna do the same thing, holding for as long as he can, about 60 seconds on each hand.
Man, that's tough.
All right, so with that being said, in a public training setting, you might not have access to these specialty pinching plates. So what you can use in exchange for those are a regular plate you can hold and pinch. And that will be that'll be similar to using the pinch block. And then you can grab the top of a dumbbell and that will simulate doing the same thing as the oscillating grip. So those are two options in a public gym that you might not have access to the loading pins and the pinching plates.
Yeah guys, very cool because this is force a lot of the grip, so it's pretty much like what you do in jiu-jitsu. Last year, for example, when I was doing physical conditioning with KP, there was one exercise we would do that we would put the thing in the bar and it would be pretty much the same principle, right? Because we would force it and stay there for like 60 seconds or so. So very good one, I love it.
Yeah, so what's unique about these pinching plates and these exercises is that it's going to increase strength and neural drive to the hands and the forearms, which will have a direct transfer to being on the mat when you grab your opponent. What you'll also notice is that when you train in a regular gym setting, the dumbbells are usually like a 1 1/4 inch diameter handle. But when you grab somebody's limb, like when I grab Bernardo's forearm, it's not 1 1/4 inch diameter,
yeah,
right? So training with thicker grips or training your grip to use thicker implements we'll have that much more of a transfer to.
No, that's very cool. Yeah. Let's jump to the second one. The next exercise we're gonna do here is gonna be the chin up with the towel. So why is it so important, Malcolm?
Okay, so chin ups are one of the best ways to increase pulling strength. So what we're gonna be doing today is using an advanced variation of a neutral grip chin up. Neutral grip means that the palms face each other. So we're gonna be using towels as the method for Bernardo to be holding on to. So not only are we working the grip, but we're also gonna be working the lat muscles and the muscles that are in charge of pulling strength. So it will have a direct transfer to when you're on the mat. All right, so Bernardo's gonna start in the extended position. So that means that his arms are gonna be fully extended and he's gonna pull himself all the way up, chin above the bar, and then he's gonna control himself on the way down and get full extension in the bottom position, just like that. So over time, if he's increasing the weight, and we have a progressive training program for that, it will increase his strength in the pulling movement, which is an essential component to any takedown.
Yeah, guys, I think this is gonna help a lot because this is like the gi, right? So when I grab here, it's kind of the same thing that we use with the gi. With KP, for example, in Iraq, there was an exercise that was pretty similar. I would put the towel around the bar and I would do like this with the weight. So you can see here that many things are similar. So the best guys are doing things that are similar to each other. Third exercise we're gonna do here is gonna be for the neck. So how is it, Waka?
Okay, so training the neck is often an overlooked muscle group for many sports, but it's a necessary requirement for combat athletes. To prevent injury, to improve posture as well as neck stability. So what Bernardo is gonna do, he's gonna use an elastic band, he's gonna wrap it around the base of his head, he's gonna step back, and we're gonna be doing neck extension exercises for the neck extensors. So if you do not have access to a head harness in a specialty gym, most gym locations will have these bands that you'll be able to use. So Bernardo's gonna step back so there's tension on the band. He's gonna flex his neck down and then he's gonna go into full extension of the neck at the top. Okay, so think of a 2 second down, 2 second extension tempo. And I'm gonna shoot for about 12 to 15 reps or something like that.
That's very cool, guys. Normally we see everybody doing this type of exercise here, right? I have seen a lot of people doing like this. So what's exactly the difference?
Okay, so you have neck flexors on the front, you have neck extensors on the back. But when you're down in the bottom position, most of the time the neck extensors are contracted more often than the neck flexors. So the neck extensors, the ones on the back, are the ones that you're gonna wanna train at the very, very beginning. The neck has many different modes of contraction, so using a progressive plan to get you ready for either a match or a competitive fight, if you're MMA, you're gonna wanna train the neck extensors first because they have the greatest carryover and transfer to what you're going through on the mat.
Yeah, that's good. Okay guys, so the fourth exercise we're gonna do here is gonna be the squat, but in a little bit different posture. Malcolm's gonna explain us.
All right, so if there's one exercise that I had to choose for combative athletes, it would be the squat. It provides so many different variations. If you need to improve your conditioning, the squat can do it. If you need to get lean, the squat can do it. If you need to put on mass and move up a weight category, the squat can do it. If you are lacking power, the squat can do it. Today, we're gonna be doing a variation of an Olympic high bar squat with heels elevated. So what Bernardo's gonna do, he's gonna get under the bar. The bar is gonna be resting on the top of his traps. Hand position is going to be elbows directly under the bar, keeping his torso as vertical and upright as possible. He's gonna walk back so that his heels are on the platform, so that his heels are elevated. This is gonna increase his ankle, his knee, and his hip mobility. So his elbows are gonna be directly under the bar. His chest is up. He's gonna initiate the movement with his knees forward and then he drops his butt down. So this exercise has way more emphasis on the quads, but it increases his ankle, knee, and hip mobility in the bottom position because he's tight. So anyone who's lacking mobility due to training too much on the mat or just being tight in general can benefit from this exercise by increasing their heels.
Guys, good to mention here that the goal is to show the how to perform. So we didn't put weights, we just make it easier to show. Awesome. Great.
And one more thing about the squat. So since BJJ is a power sport with an endurance component, if you lack power, you're gonna wanna give yourself complete rest intervals. So let's say you're doing 10 sets of 5 reps, you're gonna wanna give yourself about 180 seconds to recover before you do that set again. If you're an athlete who has great amounts of power but lacks conditioning, you can do something called an incomplete rest interval, where you do 10 sets of 5 reps, for example, but you only give yourself 60 seconds of rest. So over time, when you're progressing and adding more resistance to the bar during your workouts, that means that you're training at a higher intensity because you're using more load, so you become more conditioned with a shorter rest period.
The last exercise here is going to be an exercise for the biceps. So
what we're going to be using is a 40-degree incline bench. We're going to be doing a supinated, so that means the palm is going to be facing up, dumbbell curl. What's important to note is that in the bottom position, it's gonna put a great stretch on the short head of the biceps. The short head of the biceps attaches to the shoulder blade, called your scapula, and that's gonna help with shoulder stabilization. It's also gonna work the long head of the biceps, which its tendon wraps around the head of the humerus and holds it into the glenoid cavity. So since shoulder injuries are pretty high in BJJ, making sure that you're training the biceps and that they're strong, not only for takedowns, but also for shoulder stability, is extremely important. So what Bernardo is gonna do is start with his arms extended, palms facing up. He's gonna keep his elbows pointed to the ground, and he's gonna curl up, all the way up, all the way up, all the way up. Good, slow and controlled eccentric motion, 4 seconds down, 3, 2, 1, to full extension, and then he's gonna curl up again. Good, so in that bottom position, his biceps are great at getting a tremendous amount of stretch. That's perfect.
Man, that's very cool. And why these would be so specific for like grapplers and that?
For what, sorry?
Why these would be so specific for grapplers?
For grapplers? Because the biceps are what help with flexion. So when you grab somebody and you pull them in, or even holding them in an isometric position, from a holding position, right? Yeah. Isometrically, those muscles need to be strong as they're contracting.
Got it. Yeah, very cool.